Hey YouTube, how's it going? I'm Divesh and today on my channel Sale Cinema, I'm going to review the Shahrukh Khan, Anushka Sharma and Katrina Kaif starrer, Zero. So what is common between Rajkumar Hirani, Shujit Sarkar, Sriram Raghavan, Anurag Kashyap, Imtiaz Ali and Anand L Rai? Well, apart from the fact that all of them happen to be among Indian cinema's finest filmmakers at the moment, each of them have in the past few years either directed or express their desire to direct Shahrukh Khan. I have a question for these creative gentlemen. Why is it that whenever one of y'all finally does end up directing the Bachelor of Bollywood, your films end up striking a balance between your artistic vision as a director and the commercial expectations that automatically come with the King Khan's presence? Why do your films always end up walking a tightrope, trying to stick to your personal style as a director, as well as attempt to uphold the myth of the superstar that is Shahrukh Khan? So if Shahrukh Khan tried to reinvent himself as a reigning gangster who controls the booze trade in Rais, the character ended up being a half-hearted take at villainy because the filmmakers decided that for all his flaws, they must show a Robin Hood side to the bad guy. Likewise, Shahrukh's last film, Jab Harry Met Sejal, was supposed to be a far darker film, revolving around a man trying to commit suicide. But director Imtiaz Ali decided to opt for a happier story, keeping in mind Shahrukh's image. It is this image of the superstar that directors take a little too seriously and often allow this image to come in the way of telling a story the way it was originally supposed to be presented. Directed by Anand L Rai, who has previously directed the Tanu Yajmanu duology and Ranjana, Zero commits the same mistake of taking Shahrukh Khan's persona a little too seriously. Zero is a film that is many things at once. It's a story about a vertically challenged man who simply refuses to be content with what life gives him, and despite his small stature, constantly strives for bigger and better things. It's a love triangle featuring three fractured souls who treat each other as equals while the whole world looks down upon them. It's a film that celebrates imperfection. Its protagonists include a dwarf, a girl suffering from cerebral palsy, and an alcoholic starlet. Rather than using the physical disabilities to make us sympathize with these characters, the film scores high when it takes a look at the emotional incompleteness of these individuals. There is no doubt that director Anand L Rai knows the pulse of small town India and always excels at creating a small town feel in each of his films. In the first half, he is very much in his comfort zone as he recreates the Meerut landscape and extracts earthy performances from the main and supporting cast, giving us a slightly problematic but thoroughly entertaining first half. The second half, however, is an altogether different matter, but more on that later. Cinema very often requires us as an audience to suspend our disbelief, where there is an implied contract between actors and their audience, and the terms of that contract are fragile. It is not so easy for an audience member to suspend his disbelief for 2 hours. The storyteller has to help by telling the story consistently within the pretend parameters established at the beginning. An example would be knowing that Superman cannot, in reality, fly. The storyteller, however, tells the audience that in this story, a man can fly. The audience is supposed to suspend that disbelief and go along with that pretend premise. The problem with Zero, however, is that no matter how hard you want to suspend your disbelief and be smitten all over again by Shahrukh Khan's charm, it's truly an impossible task to do so, because the story in the second half becomes so bizarrely preposterous that you're left squirming in your seat with the pure drivel masquerading as a screenplay. How did the talented writer Himanshu Sharma come up with this? How can a film this big be so flawed at the script level? Why throw in the kitchen sink? Why not opt for a lean lithe plot that does not stray away from what the film is about? I have just one word to describe the second half. Bonkers, because logic is clearly thrown out of the window even as the plot traverses from Meerut to Mars. Yes, you heard that correctly, the planet Mars. Despite the film's many flaws, Shahrukh Khan is the one glue that tries to hold it all together. In the first half, he successfully adapts into Anand L Rai's small town world, injecting a rustic charm and mischief into his character, crafting a truly memorable Bauwa Singh. In the second half, however, it is painful to see the talented actor's good work going to waste as he convincingly tries to make us believe in the implausible second half. He's so good that he almost succeeds. Almost. Anushka Sharma's performance, however, as a NASA scientist suffering from cerebral palsy is an epic misfire. Constantly shaking like a freezing at the North Pole, trying to replicate Priyanka Chopra's manner of speaking in Barfi, and wearing a convoluted expression at all times is not what I'd call as an accurate representation of someone suffering from the condition. Kalki Kochlin was far more convincing in the 2014 film Margarita with a Straw. On the other hand, Katrina Kaif surprises us by giving us one of her best performances in her career. Her character Babita Kumari is a mercurial celebrity who cannot handle her alcohol and is known for her public breakdowns. In a classic case of art imitating life, she is also nursing her wounds from a previous relationship with a fellow actor, whose surname is Kapoor. This is not the same Katrina whose only narrative function is to dazzle us with her dance moves. This is not the same Katrina who is otherwise given a backstory of being born and brought up in a foreign land as an excuse to mask her foreign accent. This is a character that's deeper than her beauty and its trappings, and the actress sinks her teeth into it. The talented Muhammad Zeeshan Ayub seems to have been wastefully typecasted in the role of the comic sidekick. Similarly, Abhay Deol and Madhavan have little to do in meaningless cameos. Digmanshu Dhulia as Shahrukh Khan's father though is fun to watch, especially in the comic moments. It's a pity, however, that his character almost completely vanishes in the second half. As I said, Zero is a film that is many things and I'm still trying to make sense of it. From a love triangle, to an outlandish second half featuring a god-awful twist, a chimpanzee, NASA, lovers fighting in zero gravity, Chinese space stations, a whole training montage sequence ending up with a muscular Shahrukh Khan and a back-and-forth trip to Mars. This is an atrociously silly film that the whole cast and crew takes a little too seriously. My reaction after having watched the entire movie can be summed up as the following. I'm going with 1 out of 5 for Zero and an extra half star for Shahrukh Khan and Katrina Kaif for trying so hard to make us believe in the silliness of a film that has so much potential.